Using appropriate interview body language in your job interview is essential to your success. Effective nonverbal communication techniques are as important as your verbal communication skills. Nonverbal communication accounts for over 90% of the message you are sending in your job interview. Your verbal content only provides 7% of the message the interviewer is receiving from you. In this video, I'm going to speak about 5 essential body language tips to impress your interviewer. Interview posture. How to sit in an interview. What is the best posture in an interview? When the interviewer offers you a seat at the start of the job interview, sit upright, but not too stiffy in your chair. This indicates that you are comfortable and feeling confident. Hunching down in your chair gives the impression of nervousness and low self-esteem. A sloppy posture indicates a careless attitude and a lack of energy. Sitting on the edge of your chair can come across as being nervous and tense. Relax and lean slightly forward, about 10 degrees towards your interviewer. This gives the message that you are both interested and involved. Leaning back makes you appear too casual. Leaning to the side can be perceived as not feeling comfortable with the interviewer. How you position your head also sends a message. Tighten your head very slightly to one side comes across as friendly as open. Keep it straight comes across as self-assured and authoritative. Make eye contact. If the interviewer is talking and you want to show that you are actively listening, you need to make direct eye contact and maintain it. Avoid appear as if you are staring aggressively by blinking at regular intervals and moving your head every now and then, such as giving a small nod. Interview body language experts suggest that when you are doing the talking, you need to hold eye contact for periods of about 10 seconds before looking away briefly and then re-establishing eye contact. Overusing direct eye contact when you are speaking can come across as challenging the interviewers. Typically, the listener maintains direct eye contact for longer than the speaker, who breaks it off at intervals. Looking continuously downwards makes you appear insecure or submissive. It is acceptable to look down if you are making notes or referring to information in front of you. However, you are speaking or the interviewer is asking you something, raise your head and make regular eye contact to show that you are actively involved. With panel interviews, it is best to look at and direct your answer to the person asking the question with a glance periodically at that time. What to do with your hands? Control your hands by being aware of what you are doing with them. Having your hands above the neck, fiddling with your face or your hair is unprofessional and conveys nervousness and anxiety. Keep your hands away from your face. Interview body language experts will tell you that touching the nose or lips can indicate that the candidate is lying or uncertain. Folding your arms across your chest suggests a closed and defensive attitude. Waving your hands and arms around can be perceived as uncertainty and a lack of unprofessionalism. Common wisdom in that the less you move your arms and hands about, the more confident and in control you are. Practice a comfortable way to loosely place your arms and hands while you are sitting, posted at a table and in a chair on its own. Beware of your legs. Beware of the interview body language message your legs are giving. Lots of leg movement is both distracting and indicates nervousness. Resting one leg or ankle on top of your other knee makes you look too casual and comes across as arrogant. How to monitor your voice delivery? Speaking in a clear and controlled voice conveys confidence. Avoid speaking in a monotonous by varying your tone and pitch. However, don't overdo it and come across as overly excited or emotional. Breathe and pause before answering a question. This gives you time to react in a considered way and it assures that the interviewer has finished the question. You should interact with the interviewer as an equal, not a subordinate. Ensure that your voice tone is not apologetic or defensive. If you like my video, please share, subscribe my channel, and if you like to comment on the video to have more views, it's my pleasure. Thank you. And